Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week.
After hearing the word beach, the first thing that comes to our mind is the alluring seaside and the fond memories of building sea castles, while the waves roughly brushed against it, daring to wipe it out. On the topic of sand castles, we did build high palaces out of the sand when we were kids, imagining kings and queens living in them. Sometimes we even built sand sculptures that we were proud of, no matter the shape and size. Sand sculptures are a form of art that expresses the sculptor's true emotions. Some of the most unique sand sculptures from around the world achieve the recognition and appreciation they deserved. Number 1. Sand Castle in Denmark makes it to the Guinness Book of World Records. Located in the town of Blokhus, Denmark, stands the tallest structure made out of sand under the direction of the talented Dutch artist Wilfred Stinger and 30 other sculptors assisting him. It was based on the coronavirus pandemic situation, as the designs included a portrait of the virus which was built on top of the sand structure like a crown, and consisted of syringes and masked people. The structure is established at 21 meters or 69 feet, and consists of 4,860 tons of sand. It is registered in the Guinness Book of World Records after the structure in Germany, which was 10 feet shorter than the one recently built in Denmark. Stinger was inspired by the pandemic and told the newspapers as to how the sculpture symbolizes the control coronavirus has had over the world, how it has bound the people to abide by its instructions, and the helplessness of humans by staying home to save their lives from this deadly disease. The sand sculptures also contain presentations of windsurfing, kite surfing, and lighthouses, which are places of interest to tourists visiting Blokhus. Clay and glue were needed to fortify the sand castle so that it can withstand harsh weather conditions and stand in place till February or March of 2022. As a result, the tourism industry has grown in Denmark, as the coronavirus had hampered it since its beginning. Number 2. Atlantis by Sandis Kondis and Sue McGrew. Atlantis is the mythical city that sank long ago amidst the waters of the Antarctic Ocean, as the legend claims. Based on the lost city of Atlantis, sand sculptors Sandis Kondis and Sue McGrew carved this astonishingly beautiful sculpture in 2013 at a beach in Melbourne, Australia. Atlantis was even a part of the Under the Sea Sand Sculpture exhibition that was held at the Frankston Waterfront from January to April 2013. The sculpture mainly consists of a big statue of Poseidon, the Greek god of the seas, right in the middle. The frontal part is decorated with the ancient architecture of the cenotaphs and temples, which were the framework of common buildings around 900 BC, about the same time Plato told the story of Atlantis. Sue McGrew and Sandis Kondis said in an interview that they felt overwhelmed when people admired their work and appreciated the two sand sculptors. Number 3. The Magic of Egypt. Amid historical places, exclusive restaurants, spas, hotels, shopping malls, and other tourist attraction spots, France has a mind-blowing sand sculpture in the Les Touquets, which is now another popular sightseeing area for French citizens as well as foreigners. It is known as the Magic of Egypt, and is created resembling one of the most ancient sculptures in the world. It is a structure of an Egyptian king sitting on his throne. The Les Touquets beach in Picardy has the perfect atmosphere and surroundings for the sand sculpture to stand strong. It is very unlikely to break down. The sculpture gets a lot of visitors, especially the ones who have a fondness for art. Number 4. China Forbidden City. The Forbidden City of China was the imperial palace of China's former king and the winter residence of the Emperor of China from the Ming Dynasty till the emperors of the Qing Dynasty. The city got its name from the Chinese word Zaijiancheng, which means everyone is restricted from moving in or out of the city without the emperor's permission. The city is walled and is situated in the heart of Beijing. However, after the fall of the Ming Dynasty, the city lost its glamour and magic. A sand sculpture was created in the Yokohama Sand Art Exhibition in Japan, which was a transformation of the Forbidden City of China. This was sculpted by two Chinese brothers, Zheng Yongkeng and Zheng Weikeng, and is one of the most amazing sculptures of all time. The artist received heartwarming appreciation and praise from all around the globe. Number 5. Replica of Taj Mahal. The Taj Mahal, crown of the palace in Agra, India, is the most exquisite mausoleum built by the order of Mughal, Emperor Shah Jahan, in memory of his late wife, Mumtaz Mahal. It is also the tomb of both the emperor and empress. It is one of the seven wonders of the world. Sudarshan Patnaik, a talented sand sculptor, was inspired by the beauty of the Taj Mahal and created a replica of it. It stands as a 4.6 meters or 15 foot tall sand structure that took 56 hours for Patnaik to finish. It is situated in Berlin, Germany. The replica replica of the Taj Mahal was even exhibited in the Sand Sculpture Festival of Berlin, which gained a lot of appreciation from critics. A lot of tourists from home and abroad visit the sand sculpture of the Taj Mahal replica of Germany. Number 6. Replica of Michelangelo's Pietà. We all saw the famous sculpture of Pietà created by Michelangelo back in the 1400s during the Renaissance. It is currently housed in the St. Peter Basilica, Vatican City. Radovan Zivni, a professional sand sculptor from the Czech Republic who has been in this field since 1998, has recreated the Pietà in the form of a sand sculpture and has received global recognition for it. The sand sculpture resembled the Pietà so much that critics were in awe of Radovan's talent. The detailing was magnificent, almost as if the sand sculpture was created by Michelangelo himself. The sculpture of Mary holding a full-grown Christ on her lap who remains dead portrays the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. This is a very emotional piece of art to every Christian out there, which Radovan gave rebirth to in his sand sculpture of Pietà. Number 7. The Arabian Nights. Inspired by the collection of Arabic folktales widely known as the Arabian Nights, artists from all around the world participated in the Ramal International Festival in Kuwait. Sand models were made based on every story of the book, such as Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves, Aladdin and the Wonderful Lamp, Sinbad the Sailor, the Man Who Stole the Dish of Gold, the Fisherman and the Genie, and many more. These magnificent sand sculptures in Kuwait made the visitors feel that they were living inside the stories. The sculptures felt so real and engrossing. The area was measured around 28,000 square meters, or 91,863 square feet, and the amount of sand that was needed to build these sculptures was 30,000 tons. It was the largest sand sculpture festival in Kuwait and was held from January 2014 to April 2014. 73 artists joined to make this festival special and to take the tourists back to their childhood days. Many shows from the Arabian Nights are performed by actors every day. Number 8. World's Second Tallest Sand Sculpture. Former Guinness World Record winner, the sandcastle located in Rügen, Baltic Sea Island in Germany is the second tallest sand sculpture in the world, after the recently built one in Denmark. It is a castle made out of the sand by a team of sand artists, which they began to make in May. It stood firm at 17.66 meters or 57.9 feet and was made during the Sand Sculpture Festival. Binns had started this festival containing such architectural marvels in 2010 and finally achieved a world record for one in 2019 under a team led by Thomas van den Dunken. Number 9. Jarrett's Castle. Ed Jarrett, a sand artist, built a sand castle named after him known as the Jarrett's Castle in 2011. The masterpiece was situated on a beach in Farmington, Connecticut. He won the Guinness World Record for building the tallest sand castle in that year. It was built to raise money for charity, and it took around 720,000 kilograms, or 1.6 million pounds of sand and water to sculpt. 1,500 volunteers assisted in the making of this sand structure, which stood compact at 11.6 meters or 38 feet high. Ed Jarrett and his team had to put in a lot of hard work in making this sand sculpture, as it took 6 weeks to pile up the sand and then was sculpted in 11 days. However, a bluebird kept cracking the tower with its beak before Guinness could record the castle completely. It reduced in size to 11.3 meters or 37 feet tall. Still, Ed Jarrett was recognized for his marvelous piece of art and received visitors from everywhere. Number 10. Richard III Battle Scene. Richard III was the King of England who ruled the country from June 26, 1483 until his death in 1485. He was killed in the Battle of Bosworth Field, which was the last battle of the War of the Roses, following the end of the Middle Ages in England. Baldric Buckle, who was a renowned sand artist and also the founder of the Dutch sand art group called Spindaholics Anonymous, made a sand sculpture of the Bosworth battle scene on the campus of the University of Lancaster in 2015. He made use of his imagination in the production of this sand art with just a few tools, proving his incomparable talent to the world. The design of the sculpture portrayed Richard III being beheaded by a knight on a horse, and other knights and soldiers fighting a battle next to him. There is also a Shakespearean play on Richard III, where his character plays the protagonist. Number 11. Species in the Sand. Sue McGrew made a meaningful contribution to society by sculpting endangered species in the world, which are on the verge of being extinct, as a form of sand sculpture. This put light on the loss of habitat these unprotected animals are facing. The sculpture consisted of both terrestrial and aquatic animals and was made in 2019 in the Point Deviant Zoo and Aquarium in Tacoma, Washington State. The purpose of making the sculpture was obvious indeed. People needed to be aware of the consequences of their actions, the overhunting of animals, and environmental pollution, which backfires on humans. Sue McGrew pushed her point by raising awareness on this matter. That is all for today's video. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. We'll see you next time.